Shaun, so
Yeah.
what kind of form does your art take? Is it visual? Is it forming?
Yeah, it's so I'm a rapper. I do a lot of writing and performing live. So I'd say, yeah, it's mainly songwriting and performance based.
In that sector, yeah. Well, I did kind of know that because you have kind of performed with us. So when did you first get involved with all this then, Shaun?
In Middlesbrough, we have quite a we have a we have a genre of music in the northeast. Anyway, it's called Makina, and
Right.
at 13-year-old, I got my pair of
Wow.
turntables, and I
Right.
got my microphone, and we got a few friends together, and we started MCing and DJing. And then as I got a little bit older, from let's say like 13 onwards, like I was 13 when I started. Sorry, when I got about 16, 17, I started wanting to expand on that a little bit and started writing different forms
Right.
of music. So it all really started at about 13-year-old.
Right, that's great. So it's a proper passion then. It's so well, who inspired you then when you were 13? So the rap scene you were in, so who were the rappers that inspired you?
Yeah, so in the local area, there was a few people. There was a guy that goes by the name of MC Banks and MC Tempo. These guys were like, from when we were young, they were so impressionable seeing them like do like live shows and have
Yeah.
so many
And are
fans
these
and things
local
like that.
guys that you're on about? Local guys.
Local guys, yeah, from the borough. So all from the
Right.
borough. So they were part like the Makina side of things. But then
Right.
getting older, I think just like seeing people that were making a stand. So I got into like, let's say like Tupac, for instance, people that were doing stuff on the social side of things as well, and bringing up like injustices and stuff. That really got me into the rapping a lot.
So there would you say there were your influences and your inspirations then, sort of they. We've kind of covered two questions there in one, haven't we? Influences
Yeah,
and inspirations, yeah?
absolutely.
Is it self-taught what you do, Shaun, or is it? Have you watched loads of YouTube
I can't lie.
videos? So, did you just.
I've definitely watched a lot of YouTube videos as well.
You
But
picked it
when I was
up.
17, I moved to London to go to college, Kensington Chelsea College, and that's where I learned
Right.
like the production side of it. You know, like making the beats and
Yeah.
recording in the studio. Like I've got my own little setup here in my house
Yeah.
that I do most of my bits in. So I learned a lot of it at college, but YouTube videos are very handy in this day and age.
Thing is, though, I mean, I know they're handy, but it's really difficult. I mean, I couldn't rap to save my life. It's got a skill to it, hasn't it? You know what I mean? I can talk fast, but.
That's half the
So you mentioned there that you write your stuff. So do you write all this alone, or do you collaborate with people, or is it just a are you a solo performer?
Yeah, so I definitely write all my own music, and we collaborate with other people as well, other artists, but they'll write their side of the music as well. And then every now and again, we get involved in projects. I might write a little chorus for somebody here,
Yeah.
because we're, you know, in the community that we've built up of artists. So yeah, I love to write my own stuff and create everything from scratch.
Oh, that's brilliant. So, where would you normally do your stuff? Where would you normally perform?
There's a great place in Middlesbrough called the Disgraceland that I've performed that a few times. I love that place. I do, I really do, and I do. I like performing in Middlesbrough. Disgraceland's been like the place that I've performed at in Middlesbrough. There hasn't been very many other venues that have been able to facilitate that, apart from base camp as well. Yeah, I like to perform anywhere
Well,
that
we
I'll
will
have
have
me.
you back, Shaun, most definitely, because
Yeah.
the revamped Disgraceland, you
Amazing.
know, it'll be something else.
Amazing.
So, why do you think then that the creative arts are important in sort of in society and to you, sort of in general and personally?
Yeah, absolutely. I think the art is so important, especially to for expression. I
Yeah.
think society expects so much from us, you know, to be like punctual, on
Yeah,
time, polite, humble, all these
perfect
different things that we
people.
need to be. And we sometimes we just need a release, and without that release, it can, you know, like a lot of people that have been through dark times probably make a lot of great art because that suffering, you bottling it inside, and some people find it hard to open up. And the arts have always been a great release for that, you know, whether it's painting, writing a poem, making a song, doing a dance, like all these
Getting it
things.
out, yeah.
You just
Yeah,
need to let it
brilliant.
out. And it's so important for the youth as well, because there's a lot of misdirection, isn't there? And the education system could be a lot better. Let's just to touch on that a little bit.
The medication report, people
absolutely
people tend
yeah.
to like come into the medication, which, you know, there are other alternatives that, like say, you can release it all. I agree with you totally there. So finally, how do you think the lockdown's affected your work, your creativity, and what have you got in the pipeline? You mentioned earlier on a video. What have you got lined up for us, Shaun? Because we're all very excited to see this.
Oh, thank you very much. The lockdown really, it's just made me focus a lot more. With everything going on outside, you can tend to get distracted by a lot of things that you have no control over. So it's just gave me a chance to double down on my music and just really capitalise on this small window of opportunity that we've got in the music industry. And I've just released a music video called Toxic Rick. That's on YouTube and stuff like that.
Right.
You can go check that out. My name's under Shakk, S-H-A-K-K. That's my artist name. And there's a lot of other things in the pipeline with more music. I'm just looking to raise the levels. So just go on that page, subscribe to it, and keep your eye out for it.
Oh, well, we definitely will, Shaun. So your creativity is flowing.
Absolutely, yeah. It's, I feel like when there's pressure on, I can really perform at my best.
Right.
At the moment, I enjoy the pressure, and sometimes you can get too comfortable. And right now, I feel like with everybody getting back to it, now's the best time to, like, go for it, double down on everything that you do, triple down on it.
Oh, well, that's the way to do it. And I mean, I can't really wait to be open and get you back, Shaun. I can't wait. Yes,
I can't
We'll use your stage name, should we? So, Noam, anything else you want to add to what you've been? I hope I've been okay interviewing you. Is there anything you want to add to? Yeah, have you enjoyed it? Yeah,
we could go on longer.
It's nice to interact as well. We just had these certain questions, you know, because we've got quite a few interviews to do.
Yeah.
But I think I've mainly gone through most of like the bullet points that we wanted to cover. But like I say, is there anything else you want to add?
No, that's everything. Thank you very much for having me.
Yeah. Been a pleasure. So we will see you very, very shortly, hopefully.
Cheers,
and I'll get back on that video and I'll subscribe. Yeah. Yes. Ciao for now. See you soon.
Cheers, Jane. Take care.
Bye. Bye. Bye.